In this video, we're going to go through how to connect a point of sale data file to a QuickBooks financial data file. So this is when we're using a brand new QuickBooks file. So the first thing that we're going to do is make sure that we have a couple of preferences updated in QuickBooks financial. So we're going to click on that company file. We want to make sure we have it open first off. And then we're going to come over here to file, edit preferences, and then we want to turn on inventory and purchase orders, and then also go ahead and set up sales tax. So if we are going to be collecting sales tax, we want to make sure that we're collecting that as well. I'm going to go ahead and add a new sales tax item. Make sure that we have taxable and non-taxable. If we pay monthly, quarterly, or annually, we've got all that configured correctly, and I'm just going to say okay. Once we've got those two turned on, we're going to come back over into point of sale, and again we want to make sure we have that QuickBooks financial data file open that we want to connect point of sale to. And you can see in my, let me switch back to QuickBooks for just a second. I've just got a couple of accounts set up here. So this is a brand new QuickBooks file, and it's just got the regular default accounts that it automatically creates when I start a new QuickBooks data file. So I wanted to show that to demonstrate the accounts that will be added during the initial setup. So over here under File, back in Point of Sale, I'm going to go to Preferences and Company. And then I'm going to click on Financial. Then I just want to check the box for Use with Financial Software, and it will go ahead and start this connection wizard. So then I just want to click Next here. I've already got QuickBooks open. Like I was saying before, we've got to have that QuickBooks file open. And I'm just going to say Next. And then we can see here that it's now connected to that QuickBooks file. Now a couple of preferences over here on financial. We want to make sure that it's going to default to send detailed item descriptions, which is going to really bog down that QuickBooks data file. We've got all that detail over here in point of sale. So the recommended option is to choose either option 2 or 3 under here. So I'm just going to go ahead and choose option 2 for right now. That will just send summarized information over to QuickBooks Financial instead of all of that detail, because we've got the detail in point of sale. So I'm just going to click Save here. Now it's going through and updating those accounts over in QuickBooks. So if I look back at my account list, I can see the accounts that were added or created to my QuickBooks data file with that initial sync to point of sale.